Hey, surprise again, everyone. Hope you guys are doing well. I just wanted to take just a quick few minutes to hopefully support you, and especially your marketing on social media, but your marketing for your brand overall. So, how many of you have several different things that you can do for your customers, right? You have several different areas of expertise. Maybe you've been certified or licensed in several different things, whether you are a coach, a stylist, hey Sojo, whether you are a personal stylist. We normally as creatives do a lot of things. If that's you, if you've ever felt like, but I have so many things that I can offer, put me in the comments. That's definitely me. I've been an entrepreneur for over 26 years. And during that time frame, I've gained quite a few different licensings or certificates. And under those licensings, I can offer a lot of services. And oftentimes when we know that there's a customer that's coming to us, we know that there's several different ways that we can help people, right? But if you're marketing online, especially, your messaging is like super, super, super important. So when we get off of this broadcast, there's a post on my timeline. It should be underneath this particular one that says, "What do you do?" I want you guys to go in and put underneath there what it is that you do, not your website or any links, because this is specifically about messaging. And when you get clear on how to deliver your message, it will roll across in every area of your brand. For instance, if you are a life coach, or if you are a trichologist, or if you sell clothes, or you're a personal stylist, there is something specific that you do, and only you can do it the way that you do it, that is going to resonate with your ideal customer. I'm going to give you guys an example. I'll throw myself under the bus. So when I first started consulting, I was consulting with several different industries. So within my community, the Chamber of Commerce, different church affiliations. I had a fashion designer, someone who owned a magazine. So many different industries were contacting me to help them with their business, small businesses in my local community. And when I came online, I took the same direction that I had offline, online. Now, over time, that would have eventually worked, but my main area was in the beauty industry because that's where I started. So I had become known for what I did in the beauty industry in my community, but over time, people from other industries began to connect with me and contact me to either help them with their business or speaking engagements, things of that nature. But those things happened organically. But because I had a specific lane, I was able to monopolize in the beauty industry lane, and then other people were automatically attracted to what I had to offer. They saw where I could help them. So when I came online, I needed to find a new direction, right? So that I could grow my business quicker. So in a 3-year time frame, I've been able to transition from behind the chair and help other service-based businesses with their business, but I picked a lane first. And even within me helping people in the beauty industry, when I got online, I still had to be specific in my messaging because a lot of things that I was saying was not necessarily speaking to my ideal customer, meaning I might would say, you know, are you struggling to get clients? Is it difficult, you know, to get revenue in, things of that nature? And realistically, if people were in those positions, they were not necessarily my ideal customers because they often weren't in a place that they could afford the services that I offer. Hope you guys get this. And so I understood that I had a broken, and that could be literally too, message, right? And so many of you may struggle online in connecting with your perfect people. You may be getting people. So I hear often how people are gaining clients, whether they're coaching or educating in a specific industry, or whether they're, you know, a stylist, or especially trichologists. I've gotten several trichologists to come to me because they have this expertise, but one, the online market is just beginning to really know what a trichologist is. And so their messaging had to change in order to initially attract people into their business and then allow them to see the other things that they offered. So one of the things I want you guys to spend some time on, especially if you're wanting to capitalize off of your time online, is your messaging. So when you're really clear on who you are as a brand, that means you know who you are, you know the value that you offer in the marketplace, and you know who's attracted to that value, you then begin to make your marketing speak to who would ideally be attracted to your business. And this is often hard for many people because it's like, I do a lot of stuff. I don't just do this one thing. And sometimes that fear, or when we're operating in that space, and I've done it too, where it's really a lack mentality where you feel like if I get too specific, I'm gonna leave money on the table.